Now, on numerous occasions, we've gone to Ohafia in Abia State. Mm-hmm. And you know when you hear Ohafia, come on, what comes to mind? Yeah, you gotta have a big chest.
You have to be able to vibrate it.
And I carry like 10 human heads on your head.
It's three.
Okay, three.
It's three.
Well, this one, this guy now, like, the number of heads he has carried, you know, when you, he's not afraid of calling you out, man. All right? But then, I'll have your guy, Michael Stevens, eh? Okay, we've got the CEO of 20th September, whereas you know him, we know him, we call him, call him, All right, none other than Rugged Baba.
It's me. What else to say? I don't have a dance track.
Move your body, make you shake that thing where you get. Let the music enter your head. Dance your barrage. Come on, get banjo, whisk, go. Move your body, make you shake that thing.
How much, kid? You show.
Great to have you, sir. Great to have you. Great to have you.
Hello.
Great to have
you.
What's up?
Great to have you.
Thank you very much.
All right, I have a seat, sir. Thank you very much.
Have it.
I should have it.
Yeah.
Don't worry, they already told me that that's my camera, so when I'm going home, I'm taking it to me. Yeah. Okay.
All right, there's so much to talk about Ruggedy Baba. Where do we start from?
From here, I guess.
What's the best one now? Where do we start from now?
Backwards.
Let's go back.
What's backwards?
Yeah, there's something we talked about, we discussed earlier. Okay. He loves pronouncing words from the back, like calling from the back. Okay. So my name from in front is Peace. And from back is Esip. So what's your name backwards?
I won't, you know.
Please. It sounds like a god.
That's Rugged Man backwards. Is actually Namdego.
Your own, no tight reach my own.
Oh, half-year god. Hey. Namdego.
You don't have to call my own.
Okay, that was, hey.
You don't have to call my own.
He sounds god, like an Egyptian god.
Oh, God.
Wait first. Oh, yeah, I'm on here first.
No.
Don't, is it double, triple R?
Yeah. Start gen once.
It depends on the kind of generator you have.
No, that obviously sounds like an apartment my neighbor.
Okay, Ruggedy Baba, it's great to have you. But then, a number of people have gone and they seem to ask that there's been kind of, we've not seen Ruggedy Baba for a while.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, you know, you're still here.
All these talkers. Oh man.
Okay. What is it that makes people say that you've not been around for a while?
Maybe because they haven't heard me yab anybody.
You should have been a comedian, man.
I know. I've tried a bit of it. But go on my Instagram, you see, that's where I pour everything out.
So you do skits?
No, I don't do. I'm not. I'm thinking of that, but I just don't want to spoil my other market.
You know, it's cool. Nice. But then, now, we're talking about yab. Let's talk about rap music and all that. First of all, the phone lines are open. You can call in to talk to Ruggedy Baba. The numbers to call in 08091222283456 0814-00028-3N284. You can also hit us up social media, R2_TV, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, R2TV.
And Skype.
All right.
Hold up. Do you know if I was at home watching you now, I'd be like,
I know the talk comes so that you go hear from my voice. The number is scrolling across. If you touch like this, you're touching
everything.
Number. Separate
the number.
No, separate like this in the past.
They do normal thing. They scatter.
Okay, here's the father. Put your hand like this. Put your hand like this. They open your hand.
Man, block them.
You can't stop it.
You're good.
Okay, now let's talk about. Does rap artists or a rap genre of music generally, I feel that it has to be beef for it to be rap.
It doesn't have to be.
Okay, now a lot of people feel that the whole rap, for someone to be a good rap artist, the person has to be able to give and take. There has to be that. Yeah, even if it's not real beef aspect.
No, you see, that's the difference. If it's not real, it's not real.
It can be forced.
That's why you won't catch me just coming out and just doing the song and just talking to anybody or talking just like that. That's why when I did the song I did, I told people it really wasn't a personal thing. I was doing it for music. I was doing it for the industry. Okay. And that's why everything I said in that song is the truth from then till today.
Okay.
You understand? That's why even if I'm going to beef you in a song, trust me, I'm not just going to come and do the old, you mess, Spangolo, say to me, that thing. I will look at you, I will study you, and I will talk to and about you.
I need to enter.
And everything I will say is like me saying, she's wearing blue. They just look at you. Not true. That's it. That's why when I did,
okay.
You know, it was as if everything I said, people just, you know, when you are just, you're speeding and then you just match break. Just turn loop.
It's true.
Wow. That was what happened. Wow, so that's what I do. So if you're having beef and it's not real, you know, the last guy, it's just good. But check any rugged man, any so-called rugged man beef. In some last 6 years, some 4 years, take care of it. Who
let's,
are they?
Let's talk
I
about
I own
let's
the abattoir beef. For beef. Oh, yeah. And all this other
okay, beef, let's go straight into it. Let's talk. Let's go nice. Let's talk about beef.
That man. Was nice.
Yeah?
That was nice.
The way you wasn't
that was
nice.
That was very nice, eh?
But it wasn't nice.
Okay, you know, you see, there's a lot that is out there on social media, and we have different versions
of your story.
There's a lot,
that's
man.
Why don't be listening to people who don't know what's going on.
Okay, so tell us what's going on. What happened? Oh, what went
nothing.
On?
The truth.
Nothing.
The documentary.
So how did the beef just... Nothing just happened?
Yeah, well, the beef we cook rice stew. There was no meat. So we just brought beef.
God.
You got...
It got word.
Okay,
word.
See. Basically. You see what I mean by if it's not real, it will not last. Do you know how long people have been talking about this for? This
forever.
Is since 2010. Yeah. What are we in? 2016. Some people's beef didn't last 24 hours.
I
can call some names, but I don't want to.
Beef just
died on
you. Just start another beef. You know, it's like the when an Ole area boy sees someone sitting in a car and is harassing the guy from outside. Ah, don't matter. If you go, the guy comes out and like seven. Ah, Marco, God save you. Just walk away. That's how quickly that one happened. And but anyways. It was a misunderstanding. That's just about it. Nice actually sang a song talking about a past experience. And unfortunately, it happened to coincide with when he unfortunately separated from his wife. And people with the different versions.
Exactly.
Now just started saying, you know, that was probably, you know, when he starts like this, I think that was why he left his wife.
I think so too. And you know, what do you think? I think so too.
Then just to sound important, one person just gone, that's why he left his wife. That's why.
You're trying to say that you had no hand in the wife leaving.
Bro, so was I married to her or him?
You don't have to be married to her to have a hand.
Bro, okay, now no, let me ask
question.
You.
I had one version.
Did you get friend her? Did I get friend her? If I wish I did though, because she's a super girl.
Toni
Payne is one of the most industrious people I know. Okay, now let me tell you this. Toni Payne was the first person to actually ever interview Ruggedman online. If you don't know, she actually runs NigerianEntertainment.com. That was the first entertainment, should I call it blog, site where a Ruggedman interview went online. Toni Payne was the first person to actually put my music on iTunes, put my video on YouTube. And I'm talking about 2003-04. And that was exactly how I met her. I met her online. She did an interview for a friend of mine at Bounce. I saw the interview online and I was not like, man, how'd you do this? Hook me up. And it was like, it's his friend in America. That was her Yoruba name. I was not like, okay, hook me up. So he gave me her email. I emailed her. She sent me questions. I replied. And that was how, you know, but me being me, if I see an opportunity, I don't just let it go. You know, I just ask her a few more questions like, okay, what else can you do for an artist? She goes, well, she can help me put my music on, if it's good enough, she can put it on online, iTunes and YouTube and stuff. And I said, okay, fine. And I sent my songs to her and everything started from there. I didn't meet her until 3 years after because she wasn't based in Nigeria. So when I hooked up with Nice and I like Nice's music, I told him, look, I know somebody in America that helped me do so. So bring your music, let me send it to her too. So I did the same thing. She sent him interviews and, you know, the same thing she did for me, I made her do for him. You understand?
Okay.
So the same thing she did for me, I made her do for him.
Okay.
And then after that, she just called me, like, I think it was a couple of years later, I was like, if she wants to date a Nigerian artist, what do I think? I was like, oh, you know, our ally is plenty. As a artist, our ally is a plenty some.
Wow.
But, is it on your head? Whatever. If you're cool with it, fine. Then later on, she took her a couple of months and she told me who. I was like, okay, fine. If you want to. Then she came to Nigeria. I had a show at Motherland, a Binga Dinka show. That was where I introduced them.
And that was it. Wow. Okay, so now that is Genesis. One big story. One
and you know the funny part again about that particular song that started the whole wahala? It was actually Toni Payne that took the whole album to America to mix and master and bring back. Just imagine. So why would I dish you in a song, then give you the song, you too, you now collect and go and mix and make it sound well, and now bring it for us to release?
That's a question we need
it
to
doesn't,
ask.
It doesn't happen.
I want to, I know, now before I go to the next one.
Wait, before you go to the next one, I'm telling you, he's gingering. Before he goes forward, before I go forward. Now, you come from an era, or would I say a generation, where there were very hardcore rappers. Now, that's pure rap music. If it's not talking about life, it's talking about encouraging young people, there's content. What do you think about the kind of music that's produced nowadays? No. Is there a lot of Moi Moi rappers? Are you sure there are rappers everywhere?
There are rappers everywhere, trust me. And even they're still conscious rappers. Mm-hmm. There are still conscious rappers who still make the music.
But they're not popular.
They're not popular because people like you do not play them. Mm. I will say that. They're not popular because people like you, OAPs, do not play them. I'm not saying it's bad that you don't play them, but then look, because I'm only, okay. I'll say, I'm not saying it's bad you don't play them because you need your hits. You need your ratings. And to most of you OAPs, what will give you ratings is the popular, you playing the popular songs, the popular videos.
Want.
So I understand and I respect that part. Mm-hmm. But then you need to also be able to differentiate, you know, the real thing. Just because I have a great beat and I say pillow, and everybody likes it and you play it and it's your number one on your chart, pillow. Mm. Just because it's
just
popular.
Because. Okay.
Wow.
That's where I have an issue.
Yeah, imagine when banana is popular too.
Yeah, chop banana.
Man, this is bling banana or popular.
Yeah, it's bling, first of all. But come to think of it, don't you think the market really affects? Oh, come on, okay, seriously.
MC banana bling. crazy.
But a situation like in Nigeria where the market controls what is released.
Which is not supposed to be.
Oh.
It's not really supposed. The market shouldn't control what is. Because, okay, bottom line, I'll go back to the head of, to me, what I call the head of everything, which is P-Man, the body of music that's supposed to handle. Thank God, Pretty Okafor is the new president of P-Man, and he's doing his best to put a structure in place. That's the main thing that's missing, a structure. So he's trying to put a structure in place where you barcode songs, you encode tracks, and you can actually now track your downloads and everything, and you get paid for it. Mm-hmm. That's what P-Man is working on doing right now. They've even started, from what I heard, on energy, you don't collect more.
Royalties don't enter.
That kind of thing. Awesome. But we need more awareness so that more artists.
Well, no.
You know, it hurts. It pains me really when I hear an artist say, I got 300,000 downloads. But no bank alert. You understand? But someone who's registered to P-Man, who's encoded and barcoded the songs, gets 100 downloads, gets bank alert. Now imagine a Nigerian artist who have 1 million downloads.
Hey.
You see that you're hell now.
Like a superstar.
Thank you. You understand? So P-Man is trying to put things in place for it to happen proper. And then when that now happens, just like in America, we'll now have a market for every type of music. That's why in America, when they say, you're wondering why this type of music is popular, it's because it has a market and it has a budget for that they use to promote that kind of music. Just like you said, back in the days, it was all hardcore. Yes, it was. Because that was what was on the forefront. But after a while, the singing came into it, and now you have this guy, I call him Chipmunks, but he's Young Thug. Now comes into it. Oh, yeah. It's funny sounds, you mean?
Yeah.
He's just that a band, Young Thug and the Chipmunks.
Yeah.
You know, but now that type of music, trap music, is now what's in the forefront.
Mm.
Some people who do straight up hardcore will say, it's commercial.
Mm.
Bros. After the show, when we talk small now, they will just say we're going for what break?
Mm.
Commercial break. Mm. What does it bring?
Money.
Thank you. It's not about how good you are, it's about how smart you are.
You are. Mm. Okay, cool. Now let's talk about 20th September.
Why?
Now there was so much I'll tell you why, because of Mahida.
Why? Because of who?
Mahida.
I suspect.
You got Mahida to model. I don't know whether you got her. People were like, now
she got
Rugged
to make a model.
Rugged Man needs people to talk about 20 September Wears. Who's the best person to get to model his wares?
Oh, Bob's.
Mahida. And how does she do it? She goes on with no undies and puts up the 20th September wear.
No undies. Okay, no. See, when you say no undies, some people just say, no bar, no pants.
Explicit.
What's the deal?
No, it's just brand pant. There's nothing wrong with saying brand pant.
Yes.
You don't know that.
I was supposed to start making brand pant.
Okay, so what was it? Did you get her to model?
It was brand pant. Oh, sorry.
Yes, it was now.
Okay.
TSW don't enter brand pant.
I want to. I actually thought about making
lingerie.
I was thinking of making G-strings. Then a guy asked me a question. And I said, what he will ask his girlfriend is, when he sees her wearing it, he will ask her just two questions.
What
did you buy it or did he give you?
That's cool.
And I'm like, well, until then, anyways. But I'm actually thinking about it.
So did you give Mahida or did you send it to her? Which one?
She was in Nigeria, so I just called her. She's a friend. I've known Mahida for over 8 years.
Okay. Ooh.
I met Mahida in Port Harcourt a long time ago when I went for a show. Funny.
Okay.
I just finished performing. I think we were in we had this bus we went with. So I just finished performing. We were about to leave, and I was at the back of the bus, the last seat. And then somebody just came and knocked on the window. I just looked, and it was this fine-looking girl like this. I know.
Jeez,
it was a guy now. I pulled the curtain and just did that.
Do you do that? You don't do that.
No, I will hear from inside. I do a Bluetooth chop knuckle from Glasgow. I'll just do it.
So we know how to get to Ruggedman
now. No, it's not that easy. It's not that easy. You don't get to me like that.
Oh, it takes more than just being a lady.
Oscar.
You have to check.
Come on.
No comments.
So,
no comments.
I just saw the fine chick and I was like, I just told my guy, CCB. I just opened the windows more. Hello. I just did my superstar. Hello. She said, I love your music. I said, ho, ho, ho. She just did like this. And I was like, okay. She just hugged from the window or something. I said, only Nigerian bosses were like this. It was so cool. She just hugged. And then next thing, she just goes, she takes off the chain from around her neck and wants to put it around my neck.
Wow.
See, that's why I said it's not that easy. First thing that just crossed my mind, if she just put this around my neck, I'll just vanish.
Immediately
she just did it. I just did it. What's that? She said, no, it's my chain. I said, thanks. And I took it from her. And I said, thank you. Excuse me. I pray for the team. It looked good. It was gold.
Are you serious?
Trust me. I still have it in the house.
All right, cool. So my point
now
is
how we met.
Let's talk about TSW. What inspired TSW and how far do you expect to take the TSW brand?
Okay, TSW was inspired by the fact that most of the time, I love dressing casually.
Okay.
You understand? If I could wear a t-shirt to a wedding, I would. That kind of thing.
As the best man.
I know. As the best guy.
The best guy.
I can be the best man wearing a t-shirt. Okay. You know, so I like casual wears, I like t-shirts and stuff. And then coming up, I was reading magazines where you see people, where I realized or I saw that people like Jay-Z had their rocker wear. Jay-Z was involved with rocker wear. Puffy had Sean John.
Would you
John.
Do it because of you had a passion or just because
no, I had a passion,
others
boss,
were doing
not
it?
Because of, no, oh,
okay,
I had
right.
the passion. It all was right. something, see, when you're into music or entertainment, you know, look, it doesn't last too long. You understand? It doesn't right. last forever.
Uh-huh.
So you need to find other things.
Okay, before
you
go on, sir, we have a first call. We have Emmanuel on the line right now.
Emmanuel.
Emmanuel, good morning.
Emmanuel. What did you just call me?
Emmanuel.
What is it? What?
What did you just call me?
Say
Emmanuel.
Okay.
Backwards.
Rugged Man, straight to the point. Call me whatever you want to call me. I have a question for you.
Okay, whatever I want to call you.
The question I want to ask is this. We all know this is Rugged Man, but is there one thing that Rugged Man would like to change about Rugged Man?
Is there one thing Rugged Man would like to change about Rugged Man? Mba.
Why Mba now? That must be something.
Why? Do you know the thing?
What about marital status?
Marital status? Oh, that will change later now. No, that's a normal thing that will change now.
Patience.
It's the most constant thing. It's just like the most constant thing in life. Change. It will change at the right time.
Yep. Keep doing what you're doing, but just be giving us the dance song. We like the dance song.
I'm mixing it up. Don't worry. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. And give all the boys, Sawo, and all the boys, every one of them. Thank you.
He knows my songs. Thank you very much, right. Emmanuel, for calling.
So you're nice
bad
in the
guy.
End.
The bad guy.
Nice. Thank you very much, Emmanuel.
We don't have so much time. We just have to rush this. Okay. Let's talk about your... Now, he spoke about songs. Let's talk about your artists, the ones you've signed up.
Okay.
What are we to expect? What kind of artists What's do you have? And what are we to expect from the artists
The artists I have so far is Embryo. He's already done a song that's actually really going well, which is Hallelujah, featuring Pato Rankin. And I just did the remix featuring Corey Debelo, J1, and Dami Crane. Nice. The same Hallelujah we did a remix is online right now.
When are you guys shooting the video?
Soon.
And when we are, and there will be booty shaking in Hallelujah.
No, there was no booty. Okay, well, there was a fallen angel in the first one.
So how does that relate to the fallen angel? Did it make the angel fall?
The angel was there, falling, trying to tempt somebody in the video.
Okay.
20th September wears my clothing line, really. All right. So it's basically casuals, t-shirts, face caps, hoodies. If you go on TSW by Ruggedman, Twitter, Instagram, you see pictures, you see tweets.
So if I want to get TSW now, how do I access TSW? Can I order online?
You can order online. They're on all the all the top online stores, nationwide
so
delivery.
You are TSW right now?
No. You see, there was a time, people were like always saying, but you're not wearing it, you're not wearing it. I'm like, but no be uniform.
Word.
Yeah,
word,
because... You don't see him, like, I didn't get a glue on his forehead.
Word.
Thank you very much.
So go through all the artists under you and maybe something that's coming up first.
Well, the only thing right now, Rugged Records is on Rugged Man's Brief now. I took a little time off last year to start kick off the clothing line, the sales and everything officially. So now we're back to Rugged Man's Brief. Right now, I just dropped a new song featuring Olamide. And I titled it Sheishe.
Is she gonna be on it?
And it's doing really well right now.
Is she gonna be
on the song or in the video?
Yeah.
Cool.
You will know when the time comes.
Oh, he sings too.
Cool.
Sorry, I didn't say it. You will know.
Okay, so Rugged Man, how do we get in touch with you? Social media, just for
social media, socially. At Ruggedy Baba on Twitter, at Ruggedy Baba on Instagram. Last at RUGGEDYBABA Twitter. On Instagram. If you want me on Facebook, it's Rugged Man, Ruggedy Baba. If you want me, if you want the clothing line, it's at TSW by Rugged Man.
If you want Rugged Man.
If you want Rugged Man, let me be this.
This guy is about to
spit on the mic.
Where will that come
from? That mic is fairly used, man.
Let me wash it in this liquid. Wash it.
Wait, you guys are drinking black coffee.
Okay, it's been a wonderful show. Thank you very much, Rugged Man, for turning up. And he's taking us out. We'll see you tomorrow. Okay, so he's taking us out.
I'm taking you out. I just form C. Ronaldo.
Wait now.
Okay,
Rugged Records. Yoruba ru komi aje sun kan mi.